Hey everybody, this is Perch, and we're talking comic book sales and kind of the behavior in the shop. So, a nice person, nice viewer, who I've cropped the name, so I can't even know who to thank. But anyway, they asked a couple different topics, and some of these are bigger than one video, so I want to just capture a couple. And in particular, we're talking about selling comic books. So you've got some comic books, you're taking it to a shop, and you're wanting to get a good fair market value. You're wanting to, yeah, maybe even do better than market value. You're wanting to, get a good return on your investment. So the question is, I said there's a couple of questions here, but we'll tackle a couple. If I come to your store to sell a comic, how much can I get for it? Do I get more if I sell one or many? And do I get more money for certain titles over others based on trends, popularity, want list, conditions, etc., etc., etc.? So, absolutely. Well, all right. First off, there's not a one answer that fits everybody, not by a mile. So different comics, and this is something that any retailer who's any kind of a Facebook group or Google group, or now there's some Slack channels that have started up for some retailers. I'm in a couple of those, and I want to say on the offset, my shop is currently closed. I haven't had a shop, and now it's been a year. It's weird, actually, but the shop is opening up again, and I keep my eye very closely on these things, particularly in the area, because when I open up, I don't want to automatically jump into competition with somebody who's formerly a friend, or wander into a market where something has been established, and I want to know what the conditions are. But if you go to these groups, and the groups are at all, national as opposed to regional, then you'll quickly learn, and it's an easy observation to make, that different regions get different hits, different comics that are hot and not in the back issues, in back issue trade. And so when you're going to sell your comics, it's at least a good idea to kind of see if you can tune into or plug into what's currently hot. And if it turns out that the comic books you're trying to sell are not hot in the market you're trying to sell it in, let's be specific here. If you've got some 90s Image comics, you've got some Spawn. If you're trying to sell those in the Denver metropolitan area, or even up a little bit Cheyenne, Wyoming, or down south to Colorado Springs, if you're trying to sell in that corridor, you are going to get less for those comics than if you try and sell in the Dallas-Fort Worth or Houston area. Why? I have no idea. But the recruit, but at the recording time of this video, Spawn is hotter in that area than in Denver. And it's, it definitely pays to sell your comics where they're going to be hot. You will make more money. So to your questions, how much can you get for it? Most comic shops will do a combo of fair market value, which they'll determine from either lists that they see online or journals. There's a couple different places that have those. Increasingly, what I see a lot of shops do is they also supplement that with eBay. And so they'll look on eBay and they'll look at the value of the comic there. And if they know they can sell more for it on eBay, that they'll tend to go up higher than whatever, any kind of comic book journal or price guide is worth. And this is why, I mean, many shops will tell you we go by price guide. However, it's not true. Most shops, if not all shops, are looking at eBay, they're looking online, they're looking at other sources beyond just the price guide. And they should, because the price guide is pretty much, I don't want to say irrelevant, but it's becoming less relevant. It's like a single data point that is in a wildly changing market. Sort of like if you're playing the stock market and you take the current market value of a current stock and you say, all right, this is how much this stock is worth, and I'm just going to lock this in for like 90 days. I'm exaggerating, and this isn't a perfect analogy, so please nobody come in to tell me how it's off. It definitely is. But generically, this is how things are. So when you're going to sell a comic, it's a good idea to just kind of scope out what other people are selling it for, and eBay is a good place to start. And if you find that number is higher than you'd expect, you're probably in a hot market. If it's lower than you expect, you might either want to hold on to it or start fishing around to stage two, which would be see if your comic is hotter in other markets than the one you're currently trying to sell it in. Keep in mind, many shops today will sell out of region, meaning if you live in Los Angeles and you find a good buyer in Florida, you don't need to fly to Florida with your comic. If you've got something hot or something that is, considered, good in that region, or if it's a strong collector value, meaning kind of part of a run that's hard to find or just you know, historically older as a comic book. I mean, are you trying to sell kind of, you know, first printings of Civil War? Well, you know, there's a lot of those out there, and you're probably better off kind of looking to see where you can strike it hot in the market. If you're trying to sell like the first 10 issues of you know, the Fantastic Four by Lee and Kirby, you know, you're going to have a much easier time of it because you've got something more in demand. The next part of this question, I think, is really fascinating, and it's, do I get more if I sell one or many? Now, this is my own personal opinion, and I got into a fierce argument with somebody over this, but we didn't get to a conclusion. At the end of it, it almost felt like the guy turned around. He was still arguing with me, but he turned around to take my side. I believe you always get less if you sell many. Many comic stores, when they're pricing out your comics, will start to give themselves a discount if they're buying many things at once. They don't necessarily tell you this, but I know just this is the psychology of the buyer. If the buyer is buying 100 comics, then they're going to tend to, you know, certainly value the high value comics, but you're going to start to lowball everything else. And I mean, that kind of is human nature. I think you're almost always better off selling that. We'll put it this way. When you're selling a complete run of something, like you're selling, you know, an arc of a comic. And by the way, complete run doesn't need to be every single issue. Like if think about the first run of X-Force, you know, volume one. You can certainly sell the entire set of X-Force, but if you're selling the Rob Liefeld run on X-Force, you're probably fine. It's probably a smarter way to do it than selling the entire thing, because what's going to happen is they're going to rate your Liefeld comics higher than your Capullo comics down the road, and you're going to get lowballed. Whereas if you sold them both separately as separate runs, you'll probably make more money. Again, I had this big argument with somebody over this saying they like to buy in bulk, but then they kind of said the reason why I like to buy in bulk is I get a better deal. And I'm like, yeah, exactly. That's what I'm arguing, is that as a retailer, if you're buying a lot at one time, you tend to pay less, or you tend to take the lower valued comics in that pile and pay less for it. That's just, you know, that's what I would think. I think you should always be skeptical, because again, whether they tell you or not, comic shops will start thinking, hey, I deserve to give myself a discount. It's weird how that works. The second part, you know, the second question, like I said, we'll break, yeah, there's like five topics here and they're all good. But the second topic, which I'll include into this video, is back issue sales seem to be very popular right now. Are you noticing that in your store as well? Well, again, my store is closed, but yes, I do have my eye on the finger on the pulse, whatever you want to call it, of all the other stores in the area. And here's an interesting thing. We've seen some very high-profile articles about back issues doing great, and that they're selling and everybody's buying back issues. And that's been true for some stores, but definitely not all. There are a lot of retailers out there on these groups going, I have no idea what people are talking about when they say back issues are doing great. They're doing the same as always. They did not see people running into the shop with a stimulus check and just going nuts. That does not seem to be a consistent pattern. And I think that whole thing, I think, has been a little overblown. I think one person, here's the interesting thing about comic retailers, is they tend to lie. And when I say lie, it means everybody is doing great, or everybody wants to be the best or the worst, meaning I've had the worst month or I've had the best month. And when somebody comes in and says, oh man, I got a run on back issues, like, you know, I had a projection of selling, you know, $5,000 in back issues and I sold $6,000 and that was amazing. And other retailers will hear that and then say, well, I sold 8,000, I sold 10. And there's a little bit of exaggeration going on. And how do I know this? Well, you know, definitely we've seen some spikes when you look at the places like eBay, but when you go to comic shops that have their back issue stock available online, you'll notice that a lot of the kind of the high roller kind of big things are still there and have been there for a while. Now, I'm not saying, again, some shops absolutely quantitatively, there's a shop in Seattle that's definitely has seen a boost in back issue, no doubt about it. Other retailers have claimed this as well. And my personal bet is that many retailers have seen somewhat of a boost. I just think there's a lot of exaggeration going on, and it's not everybody. Which means if you're a comic buyer, you're a comic customer, then one of the things you should do is seek out some of these shops that are maybe, don't have the Twitter accounts or don't have the big hype war going on with back issues, and now's the time to buy because several of these shops are probably getting a little bit desperate to join in on this back issue kind of bonanza that they keep hearing about and not experiencing, so you can get some really good deals. In particular, I know there's a shop in Boise, Idaho. I know that there's the aforementioned a couple places in Texas and Dallas and Houston. There's a handful of shops out there in the U.S. that I know are not experiencing a massive boost in back issue sales, and they do have online sales, so you could reach out to them and probably get some pretty good deals, and that would be a pretty clever thing to do. But I some of this is hype. I see articles sometimes on in the comic news that's in EWZ sites where they talk about back issues have never been stronger, and that's a lot of hyperbole, and for what it's worth. Anyway, great questions about how to sell your comics. You have a couple more here that you asked. I apologize. I grabbed the questions and cropped your name out in the little screenshot I saved for myself. But if I'm smart and lucky, I'll be able to go back and thank you on the next round. But there you go. Some answers to your questions. What do you think? Agree, disagree, have other pieces of advice? Let me know in the comments below. Like and subscribe, and thanks for listening.